Hello viewers. Today I'm Ashal Mishra, and we are moving from Bechuan to Chengdu, and now the IRL school has come to an end. And today with us is Dr. Filippo. Catani is a professor in the Department of Earth Science at University of Florence, and he is a very famous expert of SAR interferometry. Welcome, Professor. So today I will be going to ask you some questions. So you are seeing SAR interferometry from its initial days, and have experimented a lot with SAR interferometry, its application to the areas of landslide, land subsidence. So share some of your experience with us. How do you feel about this particular technology?
Yeah, it's been a long time that we are in use of this technology now, since we're talking about 2001, 2002. It was beginning of the application of this technique to landslides, landslide monitoring, and slowly with time we discovered that it was also possible to use it for early warning. That was a very efficient technology because it gives you a very fast update of the measurements, but also because it's usable during the night, even if it's raining, if you have fog or clouds. So it's quite independent from the atmosphere, differently from optical systems. So it's quite reliable, and then it does not give you just one point measurement, but a lot of points in the area. So, and at that time, it was not usable for natural risk analysis or anything. Now it's almost 20 years that they are using this technique, and it's very diffused everywhere in the world. There are several companies producing radars, and many other radars are installed on satellites. So now it's also possible to survey the Earth's surface with this technique.
So, Professor, tell me more about this ground-based SAR. This is a very intriguing technology, and many few people have exposure to this technology. You are one of those few people.
Yeah, maybe nowadays, outside of the countries which initiate this technique, more popular technique with SAR radar analysis is from satellite, the classical INSAR. With ground-based, you use exactly the same technique, but on a radar installed on the ground, so it is possible to follow a displacement much more frequently. Instead of waiting for two satellites to come over your head and take two images, you just rely on your radar installed on the side, looking at it. Every time the radar completes a position, you can produce a new interferogram and measure the displacement. So if it's fast enough, it's possible to have one image, one measurement every 5-10 minutes. It's much faster than having to wait for weeks now for the satellite. That's the main advantage. Now there are also new technology for ground-based radar, like radar arrays, which have many antennas, so you don't need the radar to move along the radar to produce the synthetic aperture. The synthetic aperture is not needed anymore to cover the area. You can use those something very fast in displacements, because you can have one image every fraction of a second.
You are also have exposure to this this radar mounted on unmanned aerial radars, UAV-based radar on drones.
This is a new field that has been developed by several companies or institutions. at the moment, drones, as commercial drones, the one you can buy in the supermarket, they are not capable of bringing radars or interferometers because of weight limit. There is a limit of payload that you can mount on those drones. But we are developing together with the JRC in Europe a system which is lightweight and can be mounted. Other people in Switzerland, for example, they are mounting already a radar on a small UAV helicopter. It's not a commercial one, I mean, it's a very expensive drone, but still, it's already feasible. The problem now is that the radar should be, the position of the radar should be known with high precision. So at the beginning you will get a lot of noise in the images, and then you have to correct for the exact position of the drone at that moment. But it's all feasible, it's only a matter of waiting the right time for developing.
For a list of, you have to manage the weight, then you have to gather the exact position. Has to be achieved for this UAV-based SAR. So, Professor, you have been associated with the UNESCO chair, chair for sustainable management of geohazards, which is based in, I think,
Florence.
So, how do you think geospatial technologies are helping with the geohazards? How is their impact?
Yeah, I think that the UNESCO chair is the right place to make some dissemination of this knowledge. This technology is because it's open institutions and all the everybody cities also and through the work we have doing in the last 3 years for the UNESCO share, they have been selected several cases studies in the world with different, very different situations in which it is possible is being actually applied. Sorry to throw it, especially when you join this with other types of more traditional
means.
The UNESCO shares also allows for applications of very expensive, quite expensive technology in developing countries where they don't have resources to apply some types of monitoring. They can be helped in this way by setting up research agreements in which the institutions that are using this technology go place help the local people to make monitoring with this situation, and they publish the results in their research together. This is how it is needed by the
Professor. Viewers, there is this very advanced algorithm, Squee-SAR, patented by Gary Altimena, Alexander Ferranti. So, Professor, have experience with this Squee-SAR. So, share your experience with this Squee-SAR.
One of the problems we have been experiencing at the beginning of the application of multi-interferometer for satellites, giving you time series of thousands and thousands of points, was that we had a lot of reflectors on building, but almost nothing outside the field. Because of vegetation, but also the correlation of the signal was common everywhere, not just where you had vegetation. And with this new technique, Squee-SAR, it is possible to extract information also from reflectors, which are mild reflectors, but with constant coherence that can be treated statistically. This requires a lot of computational power and very developed and complex algorithms that have been developed by a team of Alessandro Fillipo and Thierry Altamira. And other people now are developing similar techniques. Different patents and systems, so there is a wide availability of these. And this is very important, especially in scanning really the top areas, you know, which you have a few houses, but still you have dangerous situations, could be risk. In that case, you end up with a larger, a very much larger number of points, so you are able to measure displacement from open fields, cultivated crops, rock outcrops, natural terrain. We are interested in this. Has been especially important lately for the monitoring of pipelines, especially gas, water, or oil pipelines. They're very fragile with respect to landslides because they can intersect. And in that case, we had not so much way to monitor them because the thousands of kilometers of pipelines, especially in mountainous areas, in the areas without buildings, it was very difficult to survey. With SAR, this is feasible because you have quite dense network of monitoring points, especially resorting to long wavelength satellites.
But it looks very like maybe.
So, Professor, you are a pioneer researcher in this field of application of SAR interferometry. So, what is your advice to upcoming researchers? My advice is for geologists or experts of landslides to learn radar interferometry because it's quite tricky. You know, you see this colored point, you think they are measurements, but you have to learn how to interpret this signal. Given the fact that the radar is given in the one direction, they give you only a component of the vector, given the fact that there are effects of atmosphere still present, and always learn how to interpret those data in the light of the geological knowledge. On the other side, the radar expert, I see the opposite. No, just try to understand the ground, the terrain, how it behaves, because you will be going to develop better tools for the science community. That's my advice. And to the young people, I strongly suggest to go into this sector because it's developing and in many other applications. So if you get succeed in becoming an expert, interferometry and widening a lot your possibilities
for your future. Thank you. We have been lucky to have your company here.
It's been a pleasure. Next time.